Hi, it's Joy, and today I'm going to be watching Stargirl Season 1, Episode 2, S.T.R.I.P.E, Stripe, which I guess is a reference to Patch or Stripe, and maybe finding out more about him and how he works and the fact that he has a giant robot, which is amazing. I want a giant robot to run around in. I'm very excited to see what this show is next. I have just finished watching the first episode, I'm going straight into the second one. As always, if you would like to watch the unedited version, as always as of now, if you'd like to watch an unedited version of this reaction, please do go on Patreon. It will be up there. If you're watching this far in the future, it may no longer be up there, but I will have until I have room, I will have it up there, and basically my shows all cycle. I am babbling. So yes, I'm very excited to keep going on Stargirl, let's go. Oh, I literally just twigged that that's his car. Yes, you can carry me, giant robot car. I'm sorry, I would be so for this giant robot car. I get a friendly staff and a robot. There are even handles. Oh, I love this. Yeah, he's not dead. Though surely, like, if he sees her, he would be like, oh, that's the girl I saw. And then he told her, like, oh, you went after my son. So she'd be like, well, I went after three boys. Whose car was it? Oh, dear. She needs to, you know, assert who's boss with the staff. Okay. No.
No, I'm not okay. He stares at me with his eyes.
And he said his son. I attacked him.
Member of the Injustice Society of America.
Is Donald Trump the leader?
I'm trying to protect you.
You know who Brainwave is. He said you attacked my son.
Did he kill my-
Hold on a sec.
No, you hold on. There's no way it's-
Sweetheart Courtney, you're gonna need a little bit of training, okay? That is magic wand. Oh, one of them, of course, is a magician and he had the moustache. Makes sense. I'm piecing it together. Slowly because I'm a bit out of it today, but-
We have a problem, William.
A child?
The others. Tell them to be prepared.
Oh dear.
No, not until we know exactly.
Work we're doing here in Blue Valley is the perfect test
case. What work are they doing?
To grant our families and to their futures.
What about everyone else's futures?
Project New America is our purpose.
Oh dear.
I'm going to locate this.
Don't think you're particularly going to be a good leader if you're intimidated by your underlings. He's a magician and he has a black cat.
And put you or your mom in danger like that. Poor Mike.
If you forgot about Mike. Poor Mike. He's going to be neglected, isn't he?
He saw you.
It was dark.
And he finds out who you are and comes.
Where's your student ID?
Probably need a mask too.
You're just going to get her more excited. I'm interested to see whether or not. I'm assuming at some point she's going to be sort of having a more of a justice society. So who else she's going to end up recruiting? But whether that's like this season or next season. She did forget to mention that he was literally like, you attacked my son tonight. So she attacked three boys, one boy's car. It's not hard to work out who Brainwave is. Just because she was being traumatized, having her first big fight with no bad guys. No excuse to forget. That is one ugly dog. He's so cute because he's so ugly. He is practicing in the middle of nowhere, unlike Courtney. Because her mum, like his wife, is going to be like, why is everyone in my family injured all the time?
Hey.
Is this the next night? When did he do all that stuff?
Who's hungry?
Huh? What happened?
Yeah, I told you she would be like, why is everyone injured? She would think they had a fight.
Great. Nice suit.
Thank you.
If he does end up being serious with her doing superheroing, I feel really bad if her mum doesn't know. It would be really crushing in a way if her daddy isn't Star Man because she's got so attached to the idea. And like, either way, it doesn't affect her superhero-ness, but...
What am I thinking?
Also, he wants to see if he's got his own power. He wants him to have his powers.
You don't steal from family.
Just from everyone else. Yes, you can't do it in school. Someone could walk in at any moment. Step it up. Maybe you need to do some measurements rather than just hacking at it. She's doing her best. I'm intrigued about what the result's going to be. Quickly before someone sees you.
Ideas, folks.
They all know better than to suggest some things that her mum probably gonna be like, I have an idea. I'm optimistic and don't think this place is a corrupt organization.
Yeah.
Oh, Pat, come on, man. Don't bring this stuff in here. What are you thinking?
That's his food and you just stole it?
You gotta make pain your friend.
Okay, you're not for me, thanks.
Make it yourself is gonna thank you for it.
And my better self's gonna be like, what was the point? What about your friends from before? I mean, they weren't really friends, but they could be. If you just turned around, you'd see.
Your
father and I have to
get... We wouldn't miss it.
I have a child to murder.
Class was in the top 1% of the nation.
Because we are supervillains. Is she looking for him and he's looking for her?
Give a hand to the backbone of this great community.
It's an evil corporation, I'm telling you. Henry, break free from your father. Do you have your own mind? That is weird, people will think of being weird with teenage girls. God, who's his kid? Can you just stop stealing his food? I'd murder him. She's doing this, you, right now. Don't have much of a choice. This is a relatively low risk area, I say, and I'm not going to eat my words when she gets attacked in 10 minutes, but...
Seems nice.
Yeah, people think so.
But it's secretly evil. She don't know. Oh no, they've seen each other. Don't go into the empty court. Why would you go to the empty corridor?
Yes, you do.
Go back to the commotion.
You'll pay for what you did to my dad and the JSA.
You're a bit early on in your superhero wing for this. But obviously, you're a creepy man, but she's brave too.
I will kill your mother if you don't bring me this back.
Oh dear, tell Pat. Rocky had a successful open house.
Nothing.
What is with that woman?
Right. You're staying here.
This is good parenting. He's trying.
Should be scared. You understand me?
What?
You're staying here. You listen to me.
You are a child. He would be irresponsible if he was gung-ho about you being a hero.
Understand what I'm saying? You stop.
I think they could have a really good relationship.
You get her out of here. Tell her I love her.
I felt that. She's going after him too. He's had a whole one workout session at the gym. He is totally ready to take on some bad guys. The mom needs to know soon.
You to know. Figure this out.
Yeah.
All right, this mom is really bad at reading, like, emotions. The brain is expecting a little girl and he's gonna get a giant robot. And then a little girl. I say little because she's quite short.
Who are you? Who am I?
You didn't think that far yet.
Someone looking for justice.
I mean, this guy's quite corny, so that works. Why are there still cars at the school? Because that means there's still witnesses around. I wonder if we kill him. Somehow, would that activate the powers in the sun and the sun could become a villain? Because then there'd be a villain of like the same age as her. Oh dear. Come on, Courtney. He needs you. You don't have time to look at your outfit and let's hope it looks good. She is getting better. I like this. It's like intuitive.
I'm Stargirl. And that's my sidekick.
You don't have time to pause and admire or be oops about property damage. Oh gosh. Come on, guys. Stuff, you're normally so good at flying around. Come on. Oh dear. Surely this has some sort of lasting repercussions.
Come on.
Gotta do something, yeah. Okay. Straight in his head. What on earth is happening? I love it. Ooh. Now is he like dead? Is he comatose? Is he not gonna come after them again? Is he out of it for good? Is this going to awaken the powers in his son? If he ever wakes up, that's not good, you know? I mean, obviously, they can't murder him. We're not murderers, but...
I never thought there'd be another star, man.
There isn't.
Stargirl.
Mm-hmm.
But whatever the case, you're the one who didn't give up. You're the one who saved me and stopped Brainwave.
No.
You.
She's a child as well. You did. If you hadn't turned the light on.
Me. This time you have a freaking robot. You can do this, Pat.
Yeah, you can. Plus, she is going to do it. So if you do it with her, that's better than you doing it without her. That's nice, given that, like...
Stargirl and Stripesy.
A couple of episodes ago, she couldn't stand him.
Stripe. Subatomic. Tactical. Robot. Internet. Pat Enhancer. Nailed it. Yes.
Pat Enhancer has got to stay.
That's cool.
Hey look, your stepdaughter finally likes you. You are in whether you want to be or not. Plus, you know, it's keeping her safe if she's doing this anyway. I still, you know, he should have some misgivings about this and I need to talk to her mother about it, which I doubt they ever will until it's too late. He's got a good evil walk. You couldn't mimic that. This is a long way to have to walk. I suppose a lot of people, if you just happen to somehow break through their biometric scanner, you'd get bored during your walk.
Hello, old friend.
Or was this the weird monster thing that was there? Hello, weird monster thing. Is it like a person that had like a weird experiment gone wrong, or a monster thing? Did he just literally walk all that way to say hello to it? Oh, it was on his way to his evil lair. I'll let you off, evil dude.
Let me show you.
Oh my god, I love it so much. They had a giant painting of themselves. Yes.
Whatever that is.
I told her doing it in the middle of town was bad.
I can kill another.
You're gonna fail, I'm afraid. That was a perfectly good screen. You had no need to go doing that. So that was a really good second episode. I think they did it well in the sense of having Pat not be enthusiastic about the idea of his stepdaughter becoming a superhero at age 15. You know, I mean, I think wanting to protect your child whatever age makes perfect sense, but it is a risky thing, like having her be a kid and having adults be aware of it is always a little bit iffy to me. Slightly. I mean, I'm willing to suspend my disbelief for it. I think if she's skilled, if she's trained, if she takes precautions, if he knows where she is, if he's with her, it's fine. I think teens being superhero type things works better when the adults don't know about it, at least at first. And then maybe when the adults find out, they're like, well, I've been doing it for 6 years and I'm totally okay, then they'll be an adult. But I like that they did it well in the sense of him trying to keep her out of it, but also him just being utterly useless at it without her, in a sense. You know, he tried his best, but even Starman was like, you're not the guy to take this on, someone else is. And so she is the embodiment of that. And you know, yeah, it would be ideal for him if she was a few years older, but she isn't. And I think if they work together, he could do a good job of trying to keep her safe. But it is also a bit iffy in terms of his marriage, because her mother has a right to know that her 15-year-old daughter is doing this stuff. And I'm going to try and not go on about that every episode, but I cannot guarantee it. Hopefully in my edited versions of this reaction, so I'll cut out some of the times I say it, but in the unedited, you'll just get me moaning on about that. I love the robot thing. I love the fact that he is a robot. They get inside of. Perfect. 10 out of 10. The staff is amazing still. I love it. I love the way that you can already see that she is building up skill with it, but she's not suddenly like, oh, I can do everything, I know the stuff. You know, she's still learning, but just intuitively she's picking up more and more pieces of how to use it, and that's brilliant. They managed to defeat the first bad guy. I thought that was good teamwork. And at the same time, it didn't, you know, he was underestimating them. So he was cocky, whereas, you know, he was all like, you're just a little girl. So then she was able to get him. You know, if he'd been like, I'm treating you like a proper adversary, I'm just going to kill you quickly, things would have gone better. But because he was a villain reveling in everything, he is now in a coma, and if he ever wakes up and remembers, they're screwed, but they can beat him again, I suppose. The danger would be if he woke up and they didn't know and he went to the house first or something. So obviously now his son is already a bully. It seems as though the mother is no longer around, is potentially dead. There was a picture up in the wardrobe and then she wasn't there with him at the open house, so I'm assuming he is motherless. So what is his life? I mean, he's very wealthy, but he's got servants and stuff. Is that okay if you're 15, 16? I assume he's around the same age as Courtney. And you've got servants. Can you just stay in your giant mansion? But I'm still wondering whether or not his father being dormant or whatever is going to kickstart his powers. Because the dad was clearly like, read my mind, which implies that he's, and the way they talked about it implied that he'd done that a lot, which makes it seem like he wants his son to have powers, he expects his son to have powers too, so it is something he expects can be inherited, maybe potentially like Courtney has inherited. So it's going to be interesting to see whether or not he becomes a villain, because I think if she ends up with villains her own age who are also coming into their powers right now, that will be much easier for her than going up against these seasoned supervillains who've maybe not been doing it so much recently, but you know, that's just because their evil plan is going along smoothly without any hero interventions. But I thought that was really interesting and really good. There was still further fleshing out of potential characters to be her friends at the school, the two girls she sits at lunch with. I would like if they became friends. The really chatty one who loves her parents and is like a school geek person, I can't think of what her name was, she seems really nice. I really like her. I think there is nothing wrong with loving your parents, there's nothing wrong with liking spending time with your parents, and there's nothing wrong with loving school, okay? But at the same time, if she were to have friends, maybe she would do a little bit less of that, and that would be healthier for her socially. And then the other girl, I think, is clearly in a very bad place at the moment. She's clearly going through a lot. It seems like pictures of hers got stolen and spread around. And yeah, she's not doing too well, so I think she could also do with a friend like Courtney, who won't take nonsense from anybody, who's also kind and sweet and has a big heart. So I think I would like it if they became friends. I don't know where the show's going with that. You know, Courtney, at the moment, they're really focusing on Courtney building up her relationship with Pat, and that totally makes sense because, you know, they presented them at the beginning as being, she was resentful of his existence, of his being in their family, of them having to move. You know, she was putting every single grump she had on him. Whereas now they've reached the point where she's choosing him and they're kind of already getting to this really strong place, and I'm excited to see that develop more. To see Courtney genuinely become at ease with the family more. I think that would be good for the mother as well, especially as she's finding out that her job is not the idealistic, wonderful thing she thought it was. The whole town is clearly part of this evil conspiracy. Now, by that I don't mean necessarily that everyone who lives in the town knows they're part of an evil conspiracy, but they are. I'm very intrigued about what their ultimate plan is. Is that just going to be one season's arc? You know, by the end of this season, we will have solved that, or is it going to go into the next season? I don't actually even know if this show managed to finish filming its season or how far through it got. So if anyone does know whether Stargirl managed to finish its run of episodes or not, do let me know. But I'm just really enjoying it. Courtney is great. I really like her. It's one of those things where part of my brain is like, yes, but you are a child, so maybe just go sit in your bedroom and be nice with your mum. But at the same time, I'm also like, well, she's very capable. You know, she's got her gymnastic ability. The staff intuitively is one with her. You know, like, she's drawn to the cosmic staff. It's cosmic. So in that sense, I think she's capable, and I think she's got the heart and the instincts of a hero. She just needs to do a lot more training. But I'm looking forward to more of that. And, you know, we've got the villains building up, and there's a lot of stuff going on. So yeah, I really enjoyed this episode. Like I said at the beginning of the reaction, if you would like to watch the unedited version of this reaction, please check it out on Patreon. If you are on Patreon, hello, thank you very much. And I'm very excited to watch next week's episode. Thank you for watching.